Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today we're looking at solving inequalities. This is part one. We'll do another video on this because it's a lot to take in one video. We use the same procedures you used for solving equations to solve inequalities. That's the good news. But we also have to solve and then graph, so that graphing is the extra piece. And there's a video on graphing. If you haven't seen it, you could watch that to see how to graph an inequality. So the same procedures we used for solving equations. If you were solving this as an equation, number one, what would you do? You'd want to get x by itself, so you would add 5 to both sides. When you add 5 to both sides, you get x is greater than or equal to 12. We're done. We solved it. We just had a different symbol in between besides before we would have had an equation. And then the graph, well, we know that the number that we're talking about is 12. That is our starting point. Should we shade the circle? Yes, because we have an equal to part. That means an additional thing we have to do, that is to shade the circle. X is greater than, so greater than goes to the right. So we solved it and we graphed it. So there's the solution and the graph. Okay, for the second one, we want to get the x's on one side and the variables on the other. And it's more important to me than ever to keep your variables on the left side. It's easier to graph. So I'm going to get rid of this x by subtracting, and 3x minus x is 2x. And now I'm going to get rid of the negative 5 by adding 5. Yes, it's minus 5, which is the same as it adding a negative 5, so I can think of that either way. The minus 5 and the plus 5 are additive inverses. They go away. And I'm left with 2x. Remember, it's less than, not equals, 7 plus 5, which is 12. Finally, just like I would in any other equation, I'm going to get rid of that coefficient by dividing both sides by that, and I get x is less than 6. What would that look like in the graph form? Well, the number I'm dealing with is 6, and I put my open circle there. Should I shade it in? There is no equal to part, so I'm not going to shade it in. And x is less than 6, and left is less, so it looks like that. And there you go. Okay, next two. 4y minus 7 is less than or equal to 19. You should try these on your own. It's good practice from your solving equation days, and it's good practice for your graphing. Add 7 to both sides, and we get 4y is less than or equal to 26. Divide both sides by 4, and you get y is less than or equal to, I'm going to reduce that to 13 halves. Not going to change it into a fraction or decimal, a decimal or a mixed number. Just leave it in that form. I'm talking about 13 halves, so that's the number that I would put onto my line. And then I have it. That's my starting point. I have an equal to part, so I would shade that. And y is less than or equal to, less is left. So notice I use the same color here, but it's quite obvious which direction I'm shading. If you're doing this on paper, your instructor should be able to tell quite obviously if you're shading left or right. Not like just kind of write it and put your arrow over the other one so then you can't tell. Make it obvious or else you're going to get it wrong. Okay, going over here, we're going to distribute. We have 4 times p and 4 times 3, 2 times p, and 2 times 6, subtracting the p's, 2p, 4p minus 2p, and then we're going to add 12 to both sides because we're trying to isolate that variable. What happens when we add 12? I keep having these things happen because I want you to see that 0 is a perfectly acceptable answer. In this case, if I divide both sides by 2, well, any 0 divided by anything is 0. So my answer is p is greater than 0. What does that look like on a number line? Well, here's my number 0. Open circle, and no, I'm not going to shade it because there's no equal to part. But p is greater than, so it goes to the right, is greater than 0. So you have four different things going here that I can show you. These two equations had open circles because there was no equal to part. One went left and one went right. And these two equations, or these two inequalities, I should say, go to the left and right also, but they have shaded circles because of the equal to part. In the next video, we will see what happens when you multiply or divide by a negative number. I need to say that because I don't want you to think you're not going to watch the next video because you understand now how to do these. There's something that's very important in the next video, so please join us for that. And for now, have a great day.